Hello students, this is Kanta Mangwani, welcomes you back. Today we are starting chapter 15, Aries. That is the second last chapter of this course, whole course. And before starting, please subscribe my channel, hit bell icon and like. So let's start. Now introduction. Till we have used data types like int, float, character and double. Etc. Okay. Now these types of variables can store one value at a time. Okay. You have seen in many programs actually. A equivalent to 10 like something like that. Okay. If we want to process one more variable, then one more variable needed in the program. See, this is a problem in a C actually. If we want to process another variable, so we have to declare another variable. That is a programs we have done. Okay, right? Now, that programs we have already done. If we want to process 5 different values, we need 5 different variables. It is a simple like. Okay, now many times program to handle large amount of data. See, there is no single data. There is always a large amount of data. So what we need? Okay, in this situation, see using special kind of data types called an array. Okay, for this type of data, large amount of data, arrays are used. Okay, why we need arrays actually? So need of arrays in the following situation. In C program, the array is used, so many different kinds of uses of the arrays actually. Maintain marks of all students of class, right? Because it is not a single student's marks, it is a 50, 80, something like that. Now maintain cost of the all products in a supermarket. So already know that in a supermarket, there are thousands of the say products are available. Now list of employees and their contact numbers. Then maintain height and weight of each students of the class. So we need arrays. To handle marks of each student instead of declaring different variables. So for this we have some special method to read the data from the compiler actually. Like marks that given that marks 1, 2 and so on. We can one variable for 50 marks, 50 students data actually. Okay. Now we declare one array variable such say 60. These are all the arrays are denoting say in the square bracket actually. Okay. Now memory array of marks 59 will look like a figure shown under. So why it is here it is a 60 and why it is a 59 actually, I already told in the many say my online classes that computer always starting counting from 0. So 0 to 59 is equal to 60. So here it is a first element say marks 0, second element 1, third 2, then so on, last element will be marks 59. Important points related arrays actually. Collection of element of the same data types. Data types should be same, like float, character, string and integers should be the same. Fixed size of sequential collection of the data, say 1 to 50, 1 to 100 like that. Okay, array element occupies contiguous memory location. Okay. It is like a same just we have seen in a previous slide actually. It is all, you know, in a side by side. Okay. Every data is a say adjacent to another data. Now element of array is an accessed by an index number. This is actually index number is given. We will discuss afterwards. Index number contain in square brackets known as a subscript. Just we have seen in a previous slide that say 0 to 59 using by the computer and we have given 60. That is called subscript. Subscript number must be an integer or an integer expression. Okay. It should be a 60, 50, 100 like that, an integer expression actually, otherwise a compiler will not take. Subscript number start with 0, it is always starting with 0 actually. Types of array. Array in C language can be classified into two categories. There are two categories, say single or one dimensional array, and second is multi-dimensional array. The single dimensional array have one row or one column. Okay, it has only one row and one column. The number of rows and column can specified by user as per requirement. That is up to programmer how many types of rows and columns. Now declaration of single dimensional array. Okay, how to declare the single dimensional array? Just check it. To declare an array in C, the data type must be specified to store in the element. Okay, we have seen in that columns are given, that is a first element, last element, like that. So data, each data will be stored in that element. Number of elements, okay, otherwise it is a number of elements, not a single. So data type, array name, here you will give the size. First is a data type. Type of element that stores an array, that is a, say integer, string, character, say float, something like that. Okay, for storing characters, type in array is character. Here you will type the character. Okay, that is a char only. For storing integers, type in array is int. You have to mention here our data type is int, that is integer, or other valid data types. We have seen in a many data types in a say 11-12 chapter actually. We have seen in a previous slide data type. Now here it is a say array name. Array name, the name given to an array as variable by programmer. Here you will give the array name. Suppose you have a student's marks, say scores, something like that. Any string suggested meaningful given name. Here you have to give meaningful name. Otherwise, if you give the whatever special characters, the compiler will not take, only underscore will take. Array name be in context of width is being stored in an array in the program. That array name will store your whole array in a one by one in that size in the program. Now last one is size. Value of size indicates the number of elements array stored. So 0 to 59, say 60 we have given here, and 0 to 59 it will take. Size must be integer greater than 0. It is always greater than 0. Example here, integer marks say 60 in a square bracket and then semicolon. Now here it is some types of say single dimensional array is given. How to declare the single dimensional array? Character string say 20. Suppose we have given say state name or say country name. Float percentage 95.95 like that. Then double numbers. Assigning values to single dimensional array. So there are two single dimensional array. Actually all can be a compile time, all can be run time actually. One is a compile time array initialization. You will give the say values in the program itself, and second is a run time array initialization. It means that you after that program compiled, then you run the program, then you give the inputs to the program. That is called runtime array. Now compile time array initialization. An array assigning values similar to a normal variable at a time of declaration. I told already actually. Now the general syntax to set the values of various array elements as follows. How you can give the say single dimensional array actually, data type, array name and then size. So in a curly bracket you will give the say values, actually value 1, 2, 3, like so on. Okay, value 1, 2 and value n provide the initial values for successive element of the array. It will store your values actually. Now here it is some example of say single dimensional array actually. Int marks, here it is given 5 in a square brackets, and here it is a 5 marks details are given, 60 to 80. Declare array store 5 elements with the value set. So how the single dimensional array store the values? In a marks say 0 element, it will store 60, then in a 1 65, in a 2 70, and a 3 element say 75, and a 4th element is 80. So 0 to 4 is equal to 5. Now during the declaration, list of values are less the size of an array specified number of element initialized. Okay, now remaining elements initialized to 0. Here is the example, int marks, here it is given say 5, but here declaration is only for marks 3, so 2 will be the garbage value. Okay, it will not take by the compiler. Initialize first 3 element as a marks 0 say 60, marks 1 is a 65, and marks 2 is a say 70. So it will take each and every by sequential. Now remaining 2 initialize value as a 0. Assigning values to single dimensional array. If the array assigned value at the time of declaration, size is optional actually. This is also having a MCQ actually. So don't specify size. Compiler automatically calculate size of the counting total number of values inside the curly bracket. For example, int marks, and here it is a size is missing. So 60 to 80 marks is given. So compiler automatically calculate that user has, programmer has given 5 array data. Now program on workbook page number 301. Compile time one dimensional array. Compile time means what? I already told that values are given in the program itself actually. So here it is given initialization of one dimensional array, that is a compile time. So we will start with the include standard io.h int main, then main function in a curly bracket int number, here it is given 5, and in a curly bracket it is given 5 values, and it is a compile time initialization. So we have given value already to the say program. Now int is equal to I, another variable we have given. So for I equivalent to 0, then if all separated by semicolon, say test condition, initialization value, and increment and decrement. So I less than 5, then I plus plus. In case what we are telling to the computer, if the I is less than 5, then I plus plus means 1 plus 1 is equal to 2, then 2 plus 1 is equal to 3, like that. So it is a loop actually that we have seen in a 14th chapter. So after this condition tested, then if value is say false, then printf percentage d backslash n, then what we want to print, that I. So here we have declared already, so that is also given in a square bracket, then return value 0, end of the program. Compile time one dimensional array output here. So just we have done program in a previous slide, that output like this. Now second is a runtime array initialization. When we need to read data from user while executing the program, when we execute the program, then we will give the data actually, inputs actually. We use runtime array initialization. Okay, now user will enter 5 marks of 5 different students at runtime of the program. So each and every, when you put the first marks, then you enter, then it will ask you the second marks. Okay, each and every marks it will ask. So see the program on workbook page number 302. Now here it is a program of say runtime array initialization. So that is also one dimensional array. So here it is given int marks 5, I, then total 3 variables are declared. Now for loop is given I, then initialization, then printf. Here it will given say enter marks, and it is in a square bracket percentage d for integer, then which variable you have to give I, because we are reading I actually. We want to read I from the compiler. Then say after this statement scanf, that is a scan formatted, and we will give the inputs are read by the compiler what and marks say square bracket I. Now second loop is given, say for I equivalent to 0 and I is less than 5, I plus plus. Okay, so it will add one value actually. Now total equivalent to total plus marks, so whatever marks you have given, that is added in a previous marks. Okay, in the last printf, the average marks of the students are percentage d backslash n, then total, here it is a total, then divide by 5, so it will give you the average actually. And two loops are given here, one for total marks and for reading marks of the 5 students, here it is loop given. Now here it is a output of previous slide program actually. So user had entered the marks say 0 to 4, that is a 5 values reading, 5, 10, whatever. Now the last is the average marks of the student is 15. So it will do that, sum of all these marks, and then it is divided by 5. Now string as a character arrays. String is a series of character or normally as a single block. So size is already given, but it will be normally in a single block actually. So group of character actually. C does not provide string as an inbuilt data type. Be remember that there is no inbuilt data type for strings actually. So but also represent string as a character array, then also it will show the string as a character array. So how it can be? So character, that is a say data type, then string name, then size of the that characters. Okay, size indicates the number of character in variable called string name. So that is a size of say character student name say 20, then character city, then 50, whatever city name you write. Okay, now character state like Gujarat and something program will come. A string in a C language terminated by the special character called null character backslash 0, that is written after the when string characters are written, so it will terminate the character string. Now this will help the program to identify end of the string. After this reading this null character, so compiler will terminate the string actually. Okay, now strings are terminated by null character, that backslash 0 require one extra storage location in character array. We remember that this is a say extra storage location. So if your value is say 6, you have to give 7. If 5, you have to give 6. Accommodate all characters of string. Okay. If you write the one less character, then it will not take. Suppose you have written 6 character and you are giving the program 6, so it will read 5 only, not 6. So similar to numeric arrays, character also initialize at compile time and runtime. For example, both are there, compile time and runtime. Character student name 6, like here it is given. Now character student name 6, here it is given in a say a single quote, that is given, and here you see that null character is given to terminate the character. String as a character array, example we have already seen in a previous slide. So reason behind 6 element in student name array, here it is. Purva contains 5 character, Here it is. Now say 1 is used for null character backslash 0 actually. Okay. Now when we initialize the character array by listing element necessary to specify null character at the end of the string. Okay, it is compulsorily to give the null character to terminate this string actually. In this case, 8 elements are used in a say character array. Our state name is Gujarat. Okay. Now here it is some example to say character string output actually. How can we derive the output actually? So printf, the name of the student is percentage s for string actually, student name, that is a variable name. The same like here, printf, the name of the state, that is also percentage s, that is state. Now third one, the first character of your name is percentage c. Percentage c for single character actually, student name, say 0. Okay. Now second one is just we have discussed about single dimensional array. Now multi-dimensional array. Single dimensional array track information in a linear single row or single column. Okay. Now if the data like chessboard, game, matrix, etc. two-dimensional array. Okay. So more than one column, more than one row actually. For this multi-dimensional data structure program used. For this we will use the multi-dimensional data structure in the program. So multi-dimensional array more than one row and column actually. Create two-dimensional array, three-dimensional array or and arrays. Two-dimensional array have row index and column index. Just check it out the next. Declaration of two-dimensional array. One-dimensional array store a list of values in it, but here it is given some example actually. Many times to store data in table, for example, this is a 3 rows and 5 columns. How it can be stored data? Let's check. One-dimensional array not applicable, right? So two-dimensional array as follows. Data type, array name, then row size first, then column size. So row size and column size must be integer and greater than 0. Now here it is given example, same first bracket declare the number of rows, it is here. Now for that table given in a previous slide, declaration of statement is as follows: int cells, then 3 rows and 5 columns. Okay, for row size 3 refers to salesman 1 in a 0, salesman 2 in a 1 and salesman 3 in a 2. While the column size 5, Monday is 0, Tuesday is 1, Wednesday is 2, Thursday is 3 and Friday is 4. Memory layout of two-dimensional array. Here it is given column index refers to days and here row index is refers to salesman and here it is 0 to 4. That is a values given. Okay, 0 to 4. Right? Now, row stores cells actually. Row stores cells 0, 0. Here it is a 0, 0. Then it is 100. Then 0, 1, 150. Then 0, 2, 200. And 0, 3 is 250. And 0, 4 is say 200. Right? So on. Okay. Now, column cells 0, 0 is 100. Here it is. And 10, that is 200. Okay, this is okay. Now cells 20 is 150. Here it is. So last cells 2 and 4, it is a 250. Here it is 2 and 4. Right? Now initializing two dimensional array, it can be a say runtime, it can be a say compile time. Both can be done. Compile time initialization 2D array, two-dimensional array. So here it is a given program. The compile time array initialization of the program as under int cells 3 and 5. Here you can give the data in a curly brackets here also, matrix data. So all data is given here. Now nested inner curly braces, here it is given. Intended salesman row. So it is a salesman row, each curly bracket. And another example here, you can directly write the whole data. So it will take 3 and 5 automatically. Runtime initialization, 2D array. Here it is given another, say, example. So the following program shown runtime array initialization of data. Say here it is given loop. Two loops are given. One is for row and one is for column. Okay, here it is. You have to put the data in when you run the program actually, right? Program segment declares 2D array cells with the 3 rows and 5 columns. Okay, now logic is that this for loop can be read total 15 different values of cells array, right? Runtime initialization 2D array. So here it is given same like a loop is given, two loops are given, for loop. So here it is, we have to enter the data. Data type is integer, and which values to be entered, that is a rows and column, that is a cells row and column, right? Students, chapter 15 is over. Hope you like this. Any feedback, any queries, any suggestion, please message me, contact me. Thanks for watching. Thank you so much.